Okay, no more singing. No more singing. Ladies and lentil beans, today is July 9, 2013, and this is the KNKL Show, episode 89. Really? Wait. Oh my gosh, it is 89. We are getting so close to the final stretch of 10. I'm your host, Keenan Lafferty, and today we are going to be doing a tutorial on drawing shoes and boots and stuff like that. How to properly fit them onto your character's feet and all of the just the basics that go into creating a boot and a shoe, and then you can take that and create your own styles and own spin-offs. But before we get into that, we need to take a stroll down the lovely lane because we got some amazing new submissions. I think I showed those last week, but let's continue. I like them so much, I'll just show them again. And let's just scroll up here. I love this. This is like an Iron Man, Captain America. Oh, we got Hulk taking his lady home. Gotta love that. Sexy Katarina. That guy from Naruto. Totally forgot his name. I'm terrible with anime. Eraser art. Man, talk about a blast from the past. Thank you very much, Simon. And you got sexy pink-haired lady. I don't know if that's also Naruto or if not. I'm sorry. There we go. Freaking Toy Story. And look at this cute little anime girl. How precious is that? So thank you very much to everyone who has been submitting their stuff to the Facebook. If you have not done so yet, please consider clicking the link below to go check out the Facebook, like it, and submit some of your stuff if the techniques that I teach you on the KNKL Show help you out. Last but not least, let's talk about the Twitter. If you are not following me, please follow because I won't bug you and spam you with pictures every time I go out to eat. You know, those people that like take pictures of their food. People that take pictures of their food and people that slobber all over themselves as they're trying to talk. Yes, I will not bother you with that. Instead, I will just update you when new videos are going live. Alrighty, people. Let's go ahead and get this out of the way. Because it is time for the tutorial. And you can see here we have a nice little... We have some preparations actually been done. And we have some notes up at the top. And we're just going to tackle each of these one at a time. And yeah, let's go ahead and get this thing underway. So the first thing we're going to be talking about today, guys, is angles. Angles of boots, angles of feet, and yeah, just drawing boots from different angles. So let's go ahead and get started with, let's start kind of with the basics of what goes into a boot and kind of the biggest things that I've learned from drawing shoes, because I used to have the problem of not exactly knowing how to make the boot look like it's just, it's over the foot, or I draw it at a weird angle. And it would look like the foot was broken underneath, and it was just always just really, really weird. So a really, really quick way to remember how to draw boots, and this really, really helps me out, is just think about it in terms of this shape. There's like this curve that comes right down here. It's like a ramp that goes right into the toe, right? And then the back of the boot just comes right up like this. And that's it. That's the basic thing right there. And then from there, this will basically be a lot like Emma's boot, right? You guys will probably recognize this. You got the little tongue that comes up right here. It's basically a piece of fabric that sits underneath the thing. Like there's two flaps that cover a piece of fabric that's underneath it. And that would be referred to as the tongue. And then you have the tread, or the sole of the shoe, I guess. Yes. Yeah, and then you can just mess around with that, make it as much, make it all kinds of different styles if you want. Sometimes I really like to kind of push the sole kind of up into the toe sometimes, especially if you're drawing like a combat type of boot. That's also something to keep in mind. And then basically there's all kinds of things that can go into creating the basics of kind of the fabric that comes up here, just like the layers of the boot, if you will. And a couple of the things that I really like to do is like the basic one would basically just to be going like this, right? Kind of comes up like from here. And then it goes right up like that. And let's actually draw this from the front as well. Let's draw the front of the boot. Or a more three-fourths perspective of the boot. Shall we? So let's go ahead and move this bad boy right up there. Let's continue with this. Let's draw it at a three-fourths angle. So again, this is something that I always struggled with, right? You just want to think about it as like kind of like the cylinder that comes up right here, right? And then this ramp that comes right down. If you were to like make this into like a geometric shape, you'd almost do this type of thing, right? See how that is almost like a half pipe that some dude would skate up onto, right? Like that, doing some tricks. Yeah, like that. Doing a method grab on there. That looks pretty good like that. So that's something that really, really helps me out when I'm drawing shoes. Just remember that ramping
thing that just goes right down into the boot. And it always looks really, really nice when you do it that way. Then, yeah, let's draw that sole on there. Like so. And I really almost like to think of it as the ramp, and then this, you know, goes straight back. Like, if you were to divide this, you could see the grid lines of this being a 3D figure in time and space. It would look like this, right? And that's the basics of how I do it. I end up kind of like rounding these things, but like just for getting started, it's really good to just remember how that works. So yeah, and hang on, let me draw the exact fabric that I did on this top one here. All right, so check this out. Right from there, where this thing is happening, we're gonna go ahead and draw that fabric up like this, and these are the two pieces that will sit over top of the tongue, right? Much like this. And I'll go right down like that, and I'll go around the other way. Okay? And there's a couple ways that this can work, actually. There can be like some sort of, you can make this all one shape, or you can do kind of like a, you can have like a subdivision here, like another, this is where kind of the styling of the boot comes into play. And there's all kinds of different things that you can do here, but basically the laces will go, you know, back and forth like this. And again, I try not to worry too much about laces, because laces are kind of a pain in the butt. That's why in the comic, all I do is I just go like that, and then I go whoop, 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 like that. Like, I make an M on there, and then it just serves as laces. In fact, this was one of the big challenges that I had to face when I was trying to create Emma's boots, was I'm going to have to draw these over and over and over again, and I want them to look cool and detailed, but at the same time, I don't want it to have to take forever to draw them, especially since the characters are simplified in their own right. I don't want to have to, I don't want to have like simple characters and then really, really detailed boots. So that was a challenge for me to figure out how to do those laces. All right, guys, so this is the basics of the boots. Let's go ahead and put them on top of our little mannequin here. And let me show you a little bit about how angles, like the angle of the foot really determines how you're going to be drawing the boot, and a couple things to really keep in mind with that. So let's go ahead and zoom in on this. And we'll actually give her some shoes, like, because you're not always going to be drawing boots. Let's kind of take shoes, and I'll show you kind of like a, do more of like a high top Converse type of thing. And I'll show you a couple things that you want to keep in mind when you're doing that. All right, so let's go ahead and work right on this layer. In fact, I'll duplicate it just so in case we mess up. Okay, so as you can see here, our model, our sexy faceless model, now she has a face, there we go. Our sexy model is kind of crossing her legs, right? So this leg is going this way, and that means that her foot is going to be pointing sort of this direction. Like, if you were to draw a perspective arrow, it would be going that-a-way, right? That-a-way. And that means that with this other leg kind of swooping in underneath here, this foot, and this is very, very important, this foot is going to be coming at us like that. Okay? And that's a very, very important thing to do, or very, very important thing to realize before you even start doing the shoes, is what angle is this foot coming at us? Because a common thing that I used to do was I just kind of started drawing. Like, here's a great example. I'll actually show you what not to do. So you've got the foot coming at us, right? And something that I really like to do with feet in general is I almost make them like little elf shoes. This really, really helps me to like just really, really quickly figure out how the feet are working, right? Because I'll do something like this. Like, say I'm, oh, stupid thing. Usually close that stupid outerwear. All right, anyway, so as you're drawing the feet, I usually like to think of them like this, right? Let's say we're drawing this foot, which is her left. So you're going to have something like this, right? And that's the bottom of the foot. I'm always thinking about the bottom of the foot. And I draw it kind of like that, because that really helps me translate it into a shoe later on. And I can draw that from all kinds of different angles, right? Like, if I were to draw it just from straight on, it would, you know, look like that. That's how I draw feet really, really quickly in the comic. And if I were to draw that foot coming straight at us, it would look something like that. Right? Like, or underneath, the underneath of the foot. It just basically looks like that. And you have a little ankle kind of peeking through there. But the most important thing to remember is just this arch that happens. Wherever the arch is, You know, if you were to draw the other foot, obviously it would be a mirror image of this, and it would look like that. And this is something that's really, really important, and actually goes into the shoes as well, because you want to make sure that your shoe doesn't look like it's like bending the wrong way. And this is actually a challenging angle to do it from, but yeah, I think that this will be good to show you how it's going to work. Okay, so let me show you a common mistake. Say I didn't, just this little sliver is just showing the bottom of the foot, and that's helping us show, or that's helping to show what perspective this is in. However, if I were to accidentally not show that, just that little thing right there, and I drew the shoe in like perfect profile, very quickly you're going to notice that her foot is going to look a little out of place. It's going to look a little broken. And I'll show you that really quickly right here. So I'm just kind of playing around with lines, and this is really kind of where it comes into play here. All right, this is where the kind of the more creativity comes into play. You can see how I've got this shape, right? Remember this little piece of fabric coming up here? That goes there, goes right up into the tongue of the shoe. And then you have that. And then my little style line, you could argue, would just comes up right through there, right? And you can put like little things in there, I don't know, just like little designs. Really, that's all up to you, and you can do whatever you want with that. Okay, so let's take a look at this. Okay, so we've got her leg coming this way, right? And just imagine, her leg is coming at us. If this was the knee and we drew like a straight line down, her foot would be a little bit broken because her foot should be pointing more, like I said, this arrow is showing where the foot should be pointing, but instead, the way we've drawn it is it's pointing almost straight in profile. And if anything, the one thing that I've learned is that people's feet have much more, like you can look at your own feet, and they have a much more, the tendency for your feet is to actually turn inward, right? It's much easier to turn your feet inward than it is to turn them outward. It doesn't go very far, right? It would be really hard for you to have your foot like that and then turn it straight to profile, right? Without your foot being broken. So that is a very, very quick just example of what not to do. Now I'm going to show you the proper way to do it. So let's go ahead and take the same thing here. And let's keep in mind our perspective once again. We've got the leg coming down. This is our knee. This is the center point coming right down here. Now let's go ahead and erase this. Let's kind of clarify this leg just really, really quickly so we know exactly what's going on. And this really helps me a lot. Like whenever I'm just a little bit unsure of what's going on with a body part, I'll always just kind of like draw a center line down, right? So this center line comes straight down here, and then it would basically meet, it would actually be a little bit more looking like this. It'd be a little bit more like that if we were to draw the underside of the foot. That point would not be there. I guess if you wanted to still put that point, it would be more like that. Okay, so now we're on to something. Now we are on to something. Now let's go ahead and throw in our basics of the shoe, right? Let's go ahead and start that. So we know that we have a piece of fabric that comes up right here. I'm gonna go right up to the top like that. And I'm just very, very quickly throwing this stuff in, and then we'll go ahead and kind of define it. And then we got the tongue there. Good stuff. Let's throw on that sole. And as we throw on that sole, let me draw this in a different color so it's very, very clear what I'm doing, what I'm drawing here. What's really important to notice is this shape right here. This underside, this is basically showing the underside of the shoe, right? And you don't want to lose this. This is like the really, really, this is like the flavor crystals of the perspective, right? And this really helps to show what's happening. So I'd be very, very careful to preserve this. And I mean, that was like such a weird shape. It's like, well, how do you come up with a shape like that? How do you know to make it look like that and then just like go up a little bit and then make it, you know, look like that, and then it just becomes the underside of the shoe? And basically the best way that I can offer advice on that is get a shoe of your own and just look at the bottom of it and then close one eye and just pay attention. Try to just notice what the shape is as it comes at you, right? Look at it from different angles and notice how more often than not, the toe always like curls up, right? You can even see it from here. See how the toe curls up? So you're always going to see a little bit of that the underneath of the shoe, right? So that's always something really good to keep in mind. You can see all the gum and stuff on there. There you go. Actually, it's silly string. It's silly string from a concert I was at on the weekend. All right. So I'm actually going to take this same shape and I'm going to push it down so that way we can show that the sole has some depth to it. Okay. So we're actually going to draw it right down here like this. And you see what that did? Now we have some depth happening here. We have some depth in the sole. The depth of the sole happening here. And that's really good. We got fabric one comes right up and goes like that. And we have the little toe here. And that goes up to our tongue, right into that. And this, you might want to pull that in just a little bit, just so it's a little bit more shapely and fitting. Fitting, yes, very fitting. And then we have style lines. Booyah! Look at that style. And then I'm going to leave it up to you to figure out what kind of style you want to do for the laces. I personally like simplified stuff, but that's just because I'm so used to doing comics and all that stuff. So I won't blame you if you'd like to do laces, but personally, I don't like it. All right, so now let's take a look at this. Now see what we've done here. We've drawn this in proper perspective, and even if it's like turned a little bit more inward, you know what I'm saying? Like, even if it's rotated a little bit too much that way, it's still okay because, like I said, your feet have a tendency that it's much easier for your feet to turn inward. And because that is her left leg, it'd be easy for her to kind of turn her foot a little bit more to the left. And it's very, very interesting that, I really believe that every, any emotion or posture or just any type of expressive pose that you're trying to capture, I feel like so much of it is told in the face, the hands, and the feet. There's so much about those things that really, really help to push an expression or like a feeling. So I really, really encourage you guys to kind of play around with that and explore positions of hands, positions and stuff like that. I don't know why I'm stumbling over my words. I can't find the right way to say it. But anyway, let's compare this to the other one. Where are we at? Okay. So we've gone from this, right? Let's actually fix this really quickly because she would not be happy. Her foot is broken, so she's very sad. She's hurt. Right? So we went from basically the knee coming down like this, and then it goes, whoa! Why is it going that way? It's like perfect profile, broken foot technique, which is bad. Don't do that. To understanding where the middle line is coming from, right? The middle line is dropping down here, and it basically continues right into the foot. And that is very, very good. So therefore, we can make this one happy. And we'll make her more sexy. We'll give her some eyelashes. Mm-hmm. And some blush. Ooh, what's up, baby? All right. So that takes care of don't break the foot. Let's do a few more angles. And we'll talk a little bit more about style as well. And then we'll go ahead and wrap up today's episode. All right, so I'm going to go ahead and get rid of these things here. Let's go ahead and make some new things up here. Let's see, what else do I want to talk about? Oh, let's actually draw this other, speaking of angles, let's draw the other foot. Let's draw the other foot and realize what's happening here. So another big thing to realize what's happening here is the leg is going in this direction. And whenever I'm a little bit unsure of what angle I should be drawing the leg at, I'll just think about the ellipses that run through it. Like if you were to see through this leg, you know, you would see the ellipses that made it up, right? As they went this way, right? And that basically tells you your angle, right? If you were to follow that straight out like a launch pad, your perspective would be going that way, right? So because of that, when it drops down, you want to think about that. The center line is on the other side of this leg. Again, using x-ray vision here. So you're actually going to be seeing the other side of the foot, the underside of the foot. The other side! So you're going to be doing something a little bit more along the lines of, and again, I always like to work with shapes first because oftentimes you can see the, like what it needs to be before you actually draw it. And that's why I work with such simple shapes. I mean, look at how sketchy all of this is. but there's still a lot of there's a lot captured here. For instance, like the shoulder coming up, showing that the weight is being placed on the hand down here. You know, it's pushing it up. Lots of little things, little subtleties that you'll pick up along the way. So let's go ahead and do this. And remember that since this leg is pointed the other way, we want to also not draw this foot or this shoe in perspective, because that means that her foot would be breaking the other way, right? So let's make sure that we are rounding the edges here and we're showing that the shoe is going this way. So I would probably do something like this. I would do the sole. I would kind of draw the sole like this. Oh, I did this on a separate layer. Yippee! I love it when I do that. Yes. Okay. So let's go ahead and stay focused. Let's draw the sole in here, right? It's looking pretty good. That's the underside, and it's going to be getting cut off, you know, by the leg here, so we don't need to worry about that. And think about the ellipses of the fabric that's coming up through here, right? You're barely going to see the edge of that, really. Barely going to see the edge of the toe there. And then this is going to come right up like that. It's going to be like that. And then this style line goes right through there like that. You might see a little bit of that tongue sticking out like that. And that's basically it. Actually, wait. I think I want to show a little bit more of the sole. Yeah, that looks okay. Again, the most important thing is just don't draw it in perfect profile, because it will look like the feet have been broken in ways that they should not be. Okay, so that's looking a lot better. I'm liking that. You got your big old Reeboks with the straps. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is looking pretty good to me. Alrighty. Yeah. So I really do like that a lot. And that's really, really helping. It's an interesting angle, too, like crossing legs, and it's like that leg is pointing that way and the other toe is pointing the other way. So I hope that really kind of helps sum things up and gives you some insight into making shoes. Now, let's go ahead and, once again, let's do a little bit more of these angles. And I'll show you really, really quick ways to set up boots, feet, and all that stuff. Let's just do a few of those sketches so you guys can see what I'm talking about. And then we will end. Okay, so sketching. So again, big thing I want you guys to do is just take a look at your shoes, and I really think like 90% of it is knowing what the bottom of the shoe looks like. I mean, you don't see this that much, so it's really good to like just take a gander and be like, oh, that's interesting. Look at that shape. It's just like a big, I don't know, sausage-looking thing or whatever. You know, I'm talking about the underside of the sole. Like, just pay attention to the different shapes that it makes. It's like, ooh, that's like a gumdrop. And then, that's kind of cool. And then, like, when it's coming straight at you. Just pay attention to things like that, and that's really going to help you out. But really, the biggest thing that I think about is just which way is the foot coming at us, and then I'll just draw the shoe kind of based off of that. Like, I like to kind of draw that arch in right there. That arch really helps to tell a lot about what's happening. And then I'll go ahead and draw, you know, the tip of that the toe there. If I can get my words out of my mouth. And then, you know, it can be as simple as doing these types of things, you know? You know, you just draw it right up, and then you got those two pieces of fabric right there, right? And then the toe. And then that shoe is now officially coming at you, right? So that's okay. I could probably do better than that. Let's try another one. Let's try another one where the shoe, let's do kind of that long sausagey looking thing, right? And again, I really like to stress that the toe curls up, right? The toe will always curl up on the shoes, right? Especially after they've been broken in. So you do something like that. I'm going to move this thing out of the way because it's kind of ugly. And again, think about that ramp. It just goes straight up like that. And then think about, remember, that geometry, right? Think of that ramp that's going this way. Because we're seeing it from the underside, right? Because we're looking at it from underneath, the ramp is going to converge down like that. See how it just like comes to a point right here? It starts thick right here, and then it comes to a point. That's just basic, you know, perspective stuff. And you'll learn to do that as you take your journeys. Okay. So let's continue here. Let's go ahead and just build off of that. That looks really good. Build right off of that. And then you go bam, bam, Bam. See? And then you have perspective. Booyah! Booyah, baby! And then laces. Let's not forget those laces. See, so it's all very, very simple. It's all about capturing the underside of the shoe. I think this really, really helps to tell it. Because also, look, watch what happens when we take away this shape underneath here. If that shape were not there, you'd look at this and be like, oh, is it kind of in profile? Is it like, what's going on? It kind of looks like it's the underside because of, you know, the relation of the fabric and the tongue, you know, but without this, it really is hard to determine what's happening with your shoe. So that's why I say probably learning how to do this right is about 90% of getting your shoes right. And that's why it is imperative that you study. Do your studying. And I want to see some awesome shoes on the Facebook after this. All right. Let's do a couple more, and then we'll just conclude with some style. Conclude with some style. And for this, I'm gonna show you guys something that was done by Poizu. Poizu did this really, really awesome fan art of Emma, and she actually made the boots look cooler than they do in the comic because of this style. Now see what I'm talking about here? Look at how the sole just wraps up around the toe, and they kind of do that in the comic. But I think what was really nice that she did was these lines in here, right? Same thing as I'm talking about the fabric right here. See those things that come up and just kind of fold over? The way that she's designed them here is just really nice. It's all about just this balance and just this piece of fabric that comes up. And this is really where your style comes in. Even at such a simple amount of detail, you can really, really pull something off that's amazing. And look at those laces. Those look pretty good. I like those laces. Very, very good. So yeah, I'm going to try to mimic that because I really like those a lot. And I'm going to draw them at a different angle. So let's take those boots and let's draw them kind of at this angle from what we had before. Oh, and while I'm doing this will also help to talk about, I want to talk about these kinds of boots that have heels on them, right? You'll see something like this, right? I'm sure you've seen this before, right? So it'll go back like that, and then your sole will kind of look something like that, okay? So again, really, I think the biggest, most important part is that you just get these shapes down. The shapes on the bottom really, really help to determine what's happening with your drawing.
Okay.
So continuing, let's go ahead and draw these lines up because this kind of like, remember, we want to curl that foot up. Curl that foot up. And we'll draw that big thing on the top of the toe there. Really like that. Looks really, really good. Now let's go ahead and draw the boot right up. And again, this really, really helps to almost think about that ramp line coming right from the toes, right? So it goes like that. And then this one, if you were to see through it, it would go do the same thing, basically. And you go right up into that. And then these pieces of fabric, well, in this case, it's a little bit more simplified. But just for consistency's sake, I'm going to go ahead and draw the fabric up like that. Fabric is going to overlap like that. And remember, it's always like this, right? Here's one of the fabric thingies. And I'm sure these have names. I call this the tongue, but I don't know what the tongue overlappy things are called. So it's always like that, right? Here's the tongue. Tongue is under here. And then the fabric comes right over top. And that goes right down into your shoe. There's a really nice detailed boot for you. All right, so let's continue. Let's go ahead and draw that right up like that. And yeah, just for consistency, I think I'm just going to... I'll do a halfway between this design and the other one. So look again, basically I've taken this thing, which is basically just another line that goes up and follows that, and I'm changing it, right? We've got this line here. Let me draw this with another thing, because these are style lines, right? And this is a whole other thing. So this line comes up like this, right? Drawn in blue so you can see. Goes up like that, and rather than mirror that perfectly and just do one of those things, what I'm deciding to do is I'm going to come up like that and go back and bring it right on up. So just change it up a little bit. Try out different shapes. You'd be amazed at like what kinds of different characteristics you can create in a boot by the shape that kind of resides on the outside of the fabric that overlaps. Yeah, I challenge you guys to try that out. And again, this is just the basics. And I've seen some people come up with amazing boot designs. It's basically off of nothing. And yeah, I'm very, very impressed by people who can do those types of things. And yeah, I hope one day I can do the same. And then you got your laces. Let's actually do this properly. I think the laces would do something more like that. Yeah, that's a little better. I don't know, I'm just not that good at laces, so we're going to call that good. Oh yeah, let's not forget the little bow tie. Bunny rabbit through the whole thing. Brilliant! Alrighty, peoples! So I hope that helps you out with figuring out how to draw your shoes in perspective, and it will help your characters not to have broken feet like mine were early in my drawing career. I didn't have any idea what I was doing with shoes, feet, or boots. But luckily, over the years, I have taken it upon myself to just learn and study, as you should do the same. And yes, you should always be improving. Alrighty, peoples! If there are any questions, please fire them off right now. I didn't even do any questions. Let's just take a couple minutes to do a couple questions at the end. And until then, I will go ahead and draw some pants on this girl. And then we will end! Let's make sure we got epic outro music. All right, sweet. Let's draw some pants on this pretty lady. Why not? All righty then. Let's give you some pants, little missy. And I should do another tutorial on folds again. In fact, I should just do another tutorial on, all my old tutorials I need to redo again, because some of them are pretty bad. I feel bad for teaching people that stuff. And they're like, what? Some of that stuff is pretty bad. But hey, we're all about improvement here, right? We're all about improvement. That's the way it should be. Cool. All right. Some people have been asking for robots and mechanical things. That is another world on its own, but I will do my best to try to get that out to you guys sometime, because I'm not the best with that stuff either. Maybe we'll just do another joint study session. Why not? We could do that. Because I've always wanted to get better at drawing robots myself. And all that good stuff. And let's give her a shirt too, so she's not naked on top. Brilliant. Pink shirt, why not? It's nice and stereotypical. Unperceived Malignity is asking, have I gotten any better at drawing feet since my old tutorial? I was actually thinking about that today, and that's the one thing that I would say I do pretty much the same. Feet, just to sum up what I did last time, feet are basically, you start with a circle, you draw a hoof off of it, like that, and then you got your little toes over here. And then you got the heel that comes up like that. And that's always been something that's always puzzled me about feet and how to draw them. Because I was always like, I guess I was thinking that the joint, I think that's really where the secret is drawing the joint here as opposed to drawing the joint on the heel, right? Because if you draw the joint on the heel, you kind of you get feet that kind of look like that. And your ankle doesn't pivot there. Like, your foot doesn't pivot on the heel, it pivots on the ankle, obviously. So just drawing this helps me to kind of capture that natural arch that's in the foot. And again, it really, really helps out when you're drawing shoes and all that good stuff. And like feet at angles really helps out a lot too, because you can do something like, let me find some empty space here. You can do one of these things. You kind of draw that, you draw the hoof down, and you got your toes that'll come out like that. And then you draw the heel right behind it. And that just really, really helps me to think of it in a few different, it helps me to think about the foot in a couple different pieces as opposed to just one giant slab of flesh, and it just looks all weird, right? I like drawing feet like that. You just want to be careful with the hoof. I think that's the only thing I would change is the hoof shape that I did with the feet before. I exaggerated a little bit too much. It was like down like that. And that's a little creepy. It should be a little bit more down, right? It should be a little bit more of a less of an angle, right? But it still applies. Much like that. So I hope that helps you guys out. I'll draw some lines on there so you guys know what I'm talking about. It's all about those ellipses, man. When in doubt, just draw some ellipses and lines on it. 3D grid lines. That really helps out. All right, last question coming in from Eric. He says, when you want a detailed character, do you draw certain things like the shoes separate very often? Yeah, to be honest, like if I were to draw a really, really detailed picture, I would take a lot of time to make sure that the shoes, I would take a lot of time to make sure that the shoes are detailed, but I think the most important thing that you do before you start putting in all the detail is you get the basic shapes down first. So I definitely would start with something like this. I would start with something even simpler, you know? Because like I said, 90% of it is just in that shape right there. So I would do something like, I literally draw something like this, right? If I was drawing like a shoe from an angle, I would do this thing and be like, okay, does that look right? No, it doesn't look right. Okay, let's try this one. I just draw a bunch of different shoes from different angles really, really quickly until I got the one where I was like, oh yeah, that one looks about right, you know, and then I just kind of expand on that. And then you start adding the detail. What I don't want you to do is be like, okay, I'm going to draw this shoe in perfect detail at a profile angle, right? And here's all the laces and here's all that stuff. And then when you're all done, you realize it was at the wrong angle to begin with. That has a lot to do with setting a good foundation, right? Going back to the basics. So make sure before you put all that detail and stuff in, you just lay down those basic shapes. I'm really starting to notice that as I continue with my art life, right, and continue pursuing art as a career and just a lifestyle, I'm starting to notice that I'm able to see things in 3D now. I'm able to just see how an object that I create in my mind, like a shoe, would look as I turn it. It's very, very interesting, and I think that this is something that just develops naturally. Same thing goes with the body, right? You know, like hands coming at you, muscles in perspective. You just start to understand how things look when they are tilted towards you and just from all different angles, and you can see them in your mind. And when you can't see them, oftentimes it's good to just find someone who can model for you, or you just find like a reference picture somewhere on the internet. Alrighty, peoples! I'd like to thank you once again, each and every one of you, for joining me live on Ustream. As usual, people on YouTube, please thumbs up if you like it, thumbs down if you don't. My name is Keenan Lafferty. I'll see you guys tomorrow. We're going to be doing whatever Wednesday, probably working on the comic, doing whatever we dang well please. All right, let's get the epic outro music here. All right, yeah, so thank you guys once again, and I'll see you tomorrow. Till then, you guys take care.